morning, say I am.
I am.
The last one was for your pastor. Let me take you to a word that is really powerfully instructive for us this morning. At times in my life, as I grow older especially, at times in my life this word comes, and it comes in ways that sometimes make me uncomfortable, but a lot of times is so profoundly reassuring for me. When I get to a place where I'm starting to get this idea that I need to be the captain of my own ship, or that somehow I should be able to direct things better than I am, or be doing better than I am, God comes with all of His words, and especially this word, to instruct my heart and life. So this morning, this word is not just for your pastor, it's for all of us here. This is what it sounds like. Through the prophet Isaiah, God is speaking directly to His people. This is what He says. He says, "My thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are my ways your ways, declares the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth," listen to that language, "as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." In varying degrees, this is something all of us do at certain times in our lives. When we think about what God is like, we tend to see Him in terms of who we are. Let me repeat that for you. Listen to this. There are places in your life and mind, especially when we feel this deep and abiding need for God to be close to us and active in our lives, when we will think about, now, what is God like? What is He like in this situation? What's He thinking? How will He act? What will He choose? Over and over again, in those situations, we tend to see God in terms of who we are. And mostly, loved ones, I find this to be true, I bet you do too. Mostly, we think that God is, in some small way at least, like us. Or we want Him to be. Okay, better, of course. We want Him to be better than we are. But in some ways, listen to me carefully, we want, we desire, in the course of our lives, especially the difficult places, we want God to, in some ways, be like us. In other words, I want God to think how I think. I want Him to choose how I would choose. I want him to chart the course that I would chart. I want Him to pick the thing that I would pick. I want, in some ways, well, better, of course, but I want God to be like I am. And yet the Scripture reminds us today as God's people, listen to it. He reminds us today as God's people that nothing could be further from the truth. The distance between us, the differences between us and our Creator are absolutely substantial in every way. I want you to hear Him this morning. Listen. This God that created all things and speaks to us through His holy word this morning, this God is perfect in His love, and we are not. While His love is full and complete and absolute and ongoing, and we're going to talk about that, ours, you hear me this morning, ours is not. I suppose in some ways we'd like to pride ourselves as human beings that there are at least some relationships in our lives where we love people absolutely and completely, unconditionally like God does. But let's be honest with you this morning. For the most part, our love comes with conditions and clauses and strings and ifs and buts. Maybe a few people in your life and mine will become closer to this kind of love that God exhibits, but for the most part, because we are limited, sinful human beings, unlike the God we belong to, we do not exhibit a love that is anywhere close to perfect. God is, listen to the phrase, God is perfect in His love. And we are not. God is, the Scripture teaches us, hear me this morning, God is generous beyond compare. And I'll say to you from my life, and I suspect in yours too, and we are not. We are, for the most part, as simple human beings, we are fairly good at being generous with those who are closest to us, kind of. So with my own children, for example, if they want or they need, almost without exception, we're going to give to them, my wife and I will give to them, almost without exception, with those who are closest to us. But as the circle of life gets bigger, listen, God is generous beyond compare. I'll repeat it for you. And we are not. I came over to church last night, early evening, to do a baptism. Renee and I did. We parked in the lot where you parked this morning. Got out of the car. There's almost nobody here. The word labors for Christ. We're coming across the church property, across the bridge that we walked across this morning. We got almost across the bridge, and I heard a voice behind me saying, "Hey, sir!" And I turned around and looked, and the lady had stopped in her car down right at the entrance of the little bridge we walk across, and she's waving me over. So I walked over and I said, "Well, what can I do for you?" She said, "Well, I'm from Nelson County, and I'm almost out of gas, and I don't have any money to get gas. Could you give me something to get gas?" And well, when I walk across the car, because I've been there a time or two, I look her up in front of the place, Nelson County. This poor woman dressed up pretty nice. She said, "I don't have gas." So here I am in this quandary. Oh, and by the way, she said, "Do you work here?" So I'm stuck in this really hard place because I know that my belt hold is sitting between the seats in my car. I know it is. And now she's put me on the spot because she knows I work here. So I walked over to my car. Now listen to me carefully. I walked over to my car and I reached between the seats and I took a $20 bill out of my belt hold. I went over and I handed it to her and I said, "Bless you." And she said, "Oh, thank you so much." And inside I'm going, "Oh, I don't want to do that." Listen. I don't really want to do that. Because, hear me today, because God is generous beyond compare, and we are not. Listen to this. God is always faithful to His word. And we are not. I'll prove it to you. How many times, Christians, have you said to someone, "I'll pray for you"? And you never did. Okay, I'll hold up my hand. How many times have you promised this, or said that, or said, "I'll do this," or "I'll do that," or "I'll carry this out," or "I'll be there for you," I'll do this. Well, listen, God is always faithful to His word. Hear me this morning, and we are not. How many things have we said to our children, told them, promised them, and then down the road said, "Oh, never mind"? How many of you are married today and are sitting there and thinking, "How many times have I said to my husband, to my wife, I'll do," and then you never did? We are not faithful as God is to our word. He is faithful at every turn. So hear me. Those differences between us and the God who created us are such a blessing for us. You see, this perfect love that I mentioned before, this love of the Father through His Son for His children, this perfect love in your life and mine, it's relentless. In Jesus, God loves you and me when we're at our best and when we're at our worst. He loves us when we're faith-filled and when we're filled with doubts. He loves us when we're people who before Him are honorable or before the world are honorable and when we're not. He loves us when we're crabby, when we're filled with joy. He loves us when we're at our best and at our worst. This love of the Father, this perfect love, which holds no strings, which has no conditions, which has no clauses, no buts, no ifs, no maybes, this love is relentless in your life and mine. It is like in some wonderfully profound way through Jesus, He is forever pursuing us so that over and over again He can take us in His arms and cuddle us up and say, "You're mine. I love you no matter what." When we first got married, is she here today? Hi. When we first got married and said, "We will and we do, I do and I will," not having any idea what followed that actually, but "I will and I do," and said to one another, "I love you. I love you. And then you start with your married life and you find out what that's really supposed to mean. And part of course, what you find out, if you've been married or you are married, you know this is true. Part of what you find out is that man is loving another person without strings or attachments. Man, that is hard work. It is hard work. And sometimes you look at him and you say, "I love you deeply. Oh, but I don't like you very much." Take this home with you. But the God you and I belong to through the Son who lived and died and rose again, this sacrificial Son, this Father, this one you and I belong to, His love for us through Jesus is relentless. When we are blowing our lives up, He keeps on loving us. When we're tracking where we should be, well, He loves us then too. When we are possible to live with, He loves us. When we are, do you know the word? impossible to live with. He loves us at every moment, at every turn, in every way, in every place. And out of that love, listen, and out of that love, he gives to his children, to you and me, so much more than we could ever deserve. He opens his hand. He purposes from his will. And in your life and mine, as his beloved children, there is gift upon gift upon gift upon gift. Today we stood and rejoiced in the fact that through the blood of Jesus, we are forgiven. Say amen.
Amen.
And we are not only loved, but heaven-bound by the course of that perfect forgiveness. Say amen.
Amen.
And then in your life and mine, oh, that's not enough. I'm going to provide food and clothing and shelter and people around you to love you like I do, or at least close. I'm going to protect your path and walk with you every step of the way. I'm going to give into your life, not because, hear me, not because you deserved it. Because I love you. I love you. And so every gift that comes from my hand and my heart into your life as my child, I want you to know I'm giving it because I love you. And always, always, always know this to be true. Always God says to us, I keep my promises. Every word that I have spoken to you as my children, every word I am faithful to, every promise I have made, I will keep. Every single one. I'll give you one today. Remember this promise, children, all things will work together for good for those who love me and are called according to my purpose. For all of my children, all things will work for good. God promises. He always keeps his promises. So that in your life and mine, whether we see it, perceive it, know it to be true or not, this holds true. God will be faithful to his word. If he said he will, he will. Because, listen, because all that's true, those differences between us and our Creator are the very heart and soul of our Christian witness. Hear me this morning. As believers, as children of the kingdom out in the world, the message that we want to share with the world around us is that God is not like us. He is so much better. It's a message I anticipate, I think you do too, every single person needs to hear. Every person in the church today that God has brought to this place, to this hour, listen, including the preacher, we all need to hear it. He's not like us. He's so much better. And because he speaks that into our lives, because we need to hear that again, the gift that rolls down for us is this overwhelming assurance in the course of my life and yours. Whatever I am going through, whatever I'm up against, whatever you are experiencing, this remains true. The God who has called you and loved you into his kingdom, he's not like you. He's better. The better ways to bless us and assure us and lift us up and keep us safe as his children. One more, listen to this. So recently in an interview, Kristen Bell, who stars in the TV show The Good Place, which is about the afterlife, right? This woman who is the star of the show about the afterlife, Kristen Bell, the blonde lady, in an interview was asked, well, do you believe in an afterlife? This is what she said. I don't think we can know. As we listen to that this morning, I want us, as God's children, to know. We can know. This God who is not like us is so much better than us, has given us not only his Son, this one whose thoughts are different, whose ways are different, who is so much higher than us, has come among us in the person of his Son. And in him we know we are loved, and cared for, and forgiven, and heaven-bound. And it gives us such assurance. Today we are grateful that God is not like us. He is infinitely more loving. He is wildly more generous. He is wonderfully more faithful. For those differences, loved ones, for those differences, we give him our thanks and praise.